narrator, Neil Patrick Harris.
What's up, everyone? What's up with the weather? Welcome to sunny Orlando, California. I'm so glad you guys have chosen to spend a part of your day here at this matinee performance of the Candlelight Processional. My name's Neil. I've been doing this for 12 years. I couldn't be more excited. It's a great way to start the holiday season. This year is actually the diamond anniversary of the Candlelight Processional. 60 years ago, Walt Disney himself did a smaller version of this at Disneyland. And we're super pleased to be carrying on the tradition as well. Who here is seeing this for the first time? Who's never experienced it? Oh my, stars? Really? Oh, that's fantastic. Well, welcome. These performers are extraordinary, and the story is tried and true. So with that, take a breath. We're here. Let's do it. Let's have some fun. And let's begin.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth to a virgin who was betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and he said, "Greetings, O favored one. The Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at the saying and tried to discern what sort of greeting that might be. And the angel said to her, "Don't be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus."
Each to his own town. And Joseph also went up from Galilee from the town of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed, who is with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to give birth. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. And in the same region, there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with great fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you, born this day in the city of David, a Savior, who is Christ the Lord." Concerning this child, and all who heard it wondered at what the shepherds told them.
Now, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who has been born king of the Jews? For we saw his star when it rose in the east and have come to worship him." And when they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy.
Mountains and valleys, and let them be shining.
to rest over the place where the child was. Going into the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they fell down and worshiped him. Then, opening their treasures, they offered him gifts: gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
The story of the birth of Christ has been told and retold for over 2,000 years. About 200 years ago, in a small church in Austria, the organist Franz came up to Joseph Moore and said, "Father Joseph, the organ is broken, and we will have no music for the Christmas Eve service." So later in the day, as Joseph made his rounds, he visited a home where a baby had just been born, and he thought about the birth of the baby Jesus. And he was so inspired that he wrote a poem, and he went back to the church, and he found Franz, and he said, "If we can't have the old organ, maybe we can have a new song, and you can play the guitar." And Franz said, "Father, I only know 3 chords. Then make a song with 3 chords. So Franz hummed and strummed, and soon he had composed the most beautiful and beloved of all the Christmas carols.
Special time of the year. And tonight, people around the world mark this joyful season with heartfelt sentiment. As we each treasure our unique holiday traditions of family and faith and culture, let's all join together in celebrating the birth of the blessed babe in a manger and rejoice in the universal message of peace on earth, goodwill toward man, joy to the world.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive, for King is here. Every heart, bring them.
given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.